assault allegations in place, a Title IX investigation as well. The football game is significantly taking a backseat to that. Having said that, though, the impact on tonight's game significant for Minnesota as three starting defensive backs, part of the group of players that are suspended. Bob Wischusa now joined by Brock Huard. And Brock, this was a saga for the last 2.5 weeks or so. What was your reaction as it happened and now that we arrive at tonight where the Golden Gophers are playing?
Well, tonight we're going to have a winner and a loser. And through this entire process, there's nothing but losers. It is just an incredibly unfortunate situation that we find ourselves in. And from a football perspective, quite honestly, this couldn't be worse for Minnesota. Defense coordinator Jay Sauvel told us as much when we met with him and said, yeah, from a matchup perspective, this is not the kind of team you want to face with only 8 healthy DBs going tonight, available defensive backs. It's been a mess.
Well, we are about to head down to the field for the celebration of what these players that are here tonight deserve, and that is a college football game that we get to call between two teams that have very 3-0 lead for Washington State as Brock, they put together a long, time-consuming drive, but end up settling for only three. Shannon Brooks from the one. To about the 22-yard line or so, maybe the 21. And Allison, you're down on a field that took a ton of rain last week, got really chopped up during the Poinsettia Bowl that was here last week. What about the field conditions tonight? They were concerned.
It definitely did. You're right. Coming into this game, there was a lot of talk about what type of condition this field would be in. And honestly, Bob, it's not that bad. I walked it earlier. It's definitely soft, but it's not nearly as muddy or as torn up as we thought it would be. There are some spots that are worse than others, especially at midfield where that paint is. And along the sidelines, it's bad too. But the kickers I talked to, some of the other players said it's okay. It's not great, but it's okay and certainly not nearly as bad as they thought it would be.
Dropped by Wolitarski. Well, the faster the track, advantage Washington State.
No, there's no doubt about it. And I'm going to be just so curious to watch that line of scrimmage, that box tonight, and you're going to see it. And they probably, Wazoo does it more than anybody else in college football. It's slight, it's subtle at times with that movement up front, but man, that can really mess with the communication, and especially with a new center in there, Mitch Leitner. that's why you've got to be committed to run. You can't go backwards. Minnesota's group is not explosive enough offensively to go backwards. But if they can continue to plod and go forward, they have an opportunity to possess, and in their case, hopefully score some points.
Third punt for Santoso and the third good one. Caleb Fossum from inside the 10. Gets a block. Flag down. Brought down at the 15-yard line. And if that block that he got wasn't the legal type, then Washington State will be starting inside their own 10-yard line.
Yeah, and it wasn't. And it was right in the back. And it's the big defensive end there, Hanser, who's on special teams. But that's pretty obvious. And when that gunner gets
during
pushed.
During the turn, legal block in the back. Number 33, return team. Half the distance to the goal. First down.
Well, if you're Minnesota and you were faced a moment ago with third down and 26 all the way back inside your 25-yard line, and now Washington State will start inside their own 10 when we come back, that is a great flip of the field. Not a bad assignment. Washington State and Minnesota in the national.
him. And we feel like we've got some linebackers that can really get after that line of scrimmage. And you're going to see here Cole Madison at right tackle. And that's all designed. You're dropping defenders out. You're changing some of those pictures for those guys. And in come those linebackers. And there goes Luke Falk's helmet right into the turf.
They narrowly avoided disaster. It was almost Gabe Marks running right into the football as Luke Falk was taking the snap.
Yeah, and what you said earlier, you know, about Adnan and Booger and the rest of the guys, as you're going to see the heavy turf and grass in Luke Falk's helmet. Now, those guys saying offensively challenged. What these both defenses are doing is getting on the edges. Both defenses are dominating the line of scrimmage, doing it in a little different ways. Wazoo's doing it through a lot of their pre-snap mechanics, and Minnesota is doing it post-snap. Right, exactly what Colorado, the Wazoo fan is saying, man, this feels like what Colorado did and what Washington did down the stretch. As you see Tavares Martin, second leading receiver now with River Craycraft lost for the season, hobbling off.
so long to her, he found out he himself had testicular cancer. So it is absolutely amazing to see him even back out on the field. And guys, it's a special night too because he's playing so close to where he grew up against the team his dad grew up cheering for. So one can only imagine the emotions he is experiencing on a night like tonight.
You're playing for the final time. I mean, this is it. And I love the commitment that Mike Leach has made to those guys up front. You want to change it? Right? You want to go from bunting to actually hitting singles and doubles and eventually home runs? Go out and run the ball first.
This time Falk has nothing and just dives back towards the line of scrimmage. It looks like he lost a yard, so it will be second down and long.
Yeah, my experience with those linemen, and we saw it in the first half with Cole Madison, the right tackle. Sorensen's played a ton of ball. This is his 34th career start. Is, you know, when a deep group defensively has your number and they're stunting and they're blitzing and you're confused, there comes a point where you say to the coach, can we just run? Can we just run right at these guys and use our size and strength? And I like the commitment here from the Cougs in the second half to do just that.
picks up about seven.
You know what this feels like, Bob? As another Gopher is down, this feels like
Minnesota Blair.
What Bill Belichick did to the greatest show on turf. You're looking at the second best passing offense in college football. And you know what he wanted to do? He wanted to disrupt Kurt Warner that night in the Super Bowl. I'll rush two, I'll rush three, but you are not going to find easy completions and get into rhythm. And the more you run, the better for us defensively.
That's Steven Richardson, who's probably the best defensive line player all around that Minnesota had healthy coming into tonight. And now he, it looks like, is having that right knee looked at. That's a slow walk off the field for the junior from Chicago. Third team all Big Ten this season, led the team in sacks and tackles for loss with 7 sacks and 11 total tackles for loss. He was honorable mention all Big Ten last season as well. And they don't have as much depth as you think they might, even on that defensive line. We've been talking about the fact that this group in the secondary is very thin because of the suspension.